Mum's a ex-professional surfer, and Dad just loves surfing and love everything about it. And yeah, Mum used to do a few events around Australia, and one of those events was in Cronulla, and I guess that's how they met. And here I am. And growing up as a kid from Cronulla, it was and having two parents that surfed and loved everything about the ocean. I just pretty much just jumped in the car and went up and down the east coast of Australia every weekend to find waves and just be an addition to their surfing trips. And as I get older, I guess, I found the love of the ocean and started bodyboarding and stuff like that. And then, yeah, jumped on Dad's board and never looked back since. I just think the ocean is just something that's so therapeutic and super hard to explain to people, but for some reason, something about the salt water, yeah, for me and for a lot of people that are huge ocean lovers, feel the same way. Feel like when I'm at my best, it's when it's all just instinctual and I'm not thinking too much. That's when I guess I do my best surfing, and I feel like that is the same theme that a lot of people have, because I feel like, we rely so much on the ocean, so it's all pretty instinctual. We can't control the ocean; we just have to adapt to whatever it throws at us. So, yeah, just being instinctual and just not overthinking anything, and just letting what I can, controlling the controllables, and then adapting to the ocean to whatever it throws at me is something that, yeah, is the best part of surfing. And that's why it's so addictive to all of us, is we never catch the same wave. Every wave's different. So yeah, that's, I guess, the addictive part of why we love it, and why I love it, and why I'm very addicted to it. As I alluded before, Mum's a professional surfer. She's actually Japanese, and yeah, so she's a Japanese professional surfer. And yeah, I guess I've got a lot of, Japan's a huge part of my life, and I spent a lot of time over there as a kid, from, say, the day I was born to pretty much 12 or 13 before I started competing and doing all that in the surfing world. So yeah, I spent about a few months of the year until I was about 12 or 13 in Japan. So yeah, it's just pretty much just around Japanese culture and how it's influenced my life and everything about that. And then yeah, it takes you through the year I had on the qualification series to get on the World Championship Tour, and yeah, some funny parts to it, and it was overall a pretty good series. Surfing isn't just competitive based. There's a lot of free surf soul vibe in the series, and it just highlights that surfing isn't just a one dimensional thing and one dimensional sport. You've got myself, who's that competitive side of it, and then you've got a few of the other guys who are just the soul carefree free surfers that just surf and travel around Japan and highlight how good surfing really is and how fun it is. So yeah, there's a lot of vast personalities and all that, which makes it super exciting to watch. I feel like with being a professional surfer, everyone just sees the great things about it, the travel, the we're always chasing summer, the warm water, the tropical weather, and there's definitely a lot of lowlights in every sporting profession, but especially surfing as well. So just to highlight that there are a lot of lows in the sport of surfing, and to show people that, we're only human, and hopefully motivate a lot of people that we all, I'm at the highest level of my sport, but I still go through a lot of the lows. And yeah, it's just to influence, hopefully influence people that we all go through the lows, and it's just a matter of adapting and moving forward with it, instead of just acting like the world's over when something goes bad. So yeah, I wasn't a confident kid growing up, and I just kind of wanted to just go through school and not be that center of attention and just kind of be on the back of the pack and just cruise through school. And so yeah, I kind of, but having a Japanese culture definitely put me into that center of attention because I was different, and I was multicultural. And so therefore I spent a lot of my childhood kind of putting it behind me, which I look back now and think it's ridiculous. But yeah, just to try and fit in, I wanted to be as Australian as I could. So yeah, I did that. And then, yeah, I guess as I've grown older and matured and traveled around the world doing what I do, it's come to make me realize how great of, you know, how honored I am to be multicultural and have the Australian and Japanese in my life. So yeah, I've got a great fan base over there. I've got great families and friends over in Japan. So it was just, yeah, it's great to be able to represent two vastly different cultures on the world stage of surfing. On our competition jerseys, we have two flags on each shoulder. And because I've, you know, I'm half-half, my wife was like, you know, why not ask them to see if you can put a Japanese flag on one and an Australian one on the other. And yeah, it kind of started from there. And then stemmed onto my, you know, opening up that being able to represent Japan as well on the world stage as well as Australia is something that I feel like I want to do it at the very best. And like I said before, I've got a lot of fan base over there. So to be able to represent them at the highest level is something that I'd love to do as well as represent Australia as best as I could. Yeah, it was amazing to not only have surfing introduced into the Olympics, but to have the very first one in Japan was a huge one. Surfing has such a big influence in Japan. You know, there's so many Japanese surfers and fans of surfing coming out of Japan. So to have the first Olympics in Japan was humongous for not only a lot of the Japanese people for the world, but even for the Japanese kids to influence them to go, you know, maybe while one day I can be an Olympian, if I try hard and work on things in surfing, then I can be there one day. So yeah, it's onwards and upwards. I guess for myself as a kid, I never would have thought that I'd be in the position that I am today. And, you know, with a lot of hard work and dedication towards improving in my surfing has led me here. So yeah, I just want to do well for them and do well for everyone that is supporting me. Because yeah, mum and dad have spent countless hours on the beach, you're watching me and grabbing the handy cam and filming me surf and been through the highs and lows with me. So yeah, it's just yeah, wanting to do well for them. But at the end of the day, I just want to just perform and entertain. We're all entertainers at the end of the day. So if I'm doing that, then I'm doing my job. So yeah,